That was the only thing I noticed.
Bezel looks okay. It's a nice watch.
No, that's nice.
You bought it at Rolex?
No, I bought it off a jeweler.
So he brought us in the 326938 yellow gold Sky-Dweller, black face. Saw a little chip on the crystal, so that's going to be a replacement cost for us. But to stock the watch and be in mid-30s, maybe even low-30s, I don't really want to stock it, but I have a customer that wants this watch, so we're waiting on the customer to call me back. If he gives me verbal confirmation, I'll hand him a check probably for 36.5 or 37,000 and then sell the watch. So we're just waiting.
Yeah. I've had probably every Sky-Dweller. I've had the yellow gold champagne, the rose gold sundial. I haven't had the chocolate though. I had the blue face.
We have the chocolate, we have the chocolate
with the
Sky-Dweller
on Oyster Flex? With the Oyster Flex. I'm a full gold, full metal kind of guy.
You wanna see it while you wait?
Yeah, let me see it. $36.5
for that.
The most comfortable bracelet.
Yeah, no, it is. I've never actually put Oyster Flex on.
Right.
Yeah, that's what I was like, what? I was thinking.
Kind of.
Yeah, this one here.
Yeah. Now that's fire, though. That is fire. They go for 130?
Yeah.
Good investment? What do you think?
That one? Yeah.
Yeah?
Not too many people have that.
Yeah, that's a beautiful watch.
It's a great price.
Yeah, super good.
Yeah, other dealers were selling at like 175.
Yeah.
The Daytona. Because on most Rolexes, if they have a white face,
it's kind of I think it's the white and the black and the red. And you know that when they give it a name, that just shoots up as well, right?
The two-tone Sky-Dweller, we're shipping it out today.
Yeah.
It took us forever to sell.
Yeah.
It had the white dial.
Yeah. I had that. I actually made money. My first watch was a Submariner. But I got it for $4,200. I'd like to say like 2014. But yeah.
Everyone that comes in here, they always think about that.
Yeah.
Like, you used to be able to buy this for four.
Yeah, it's crazy. No, I even brought my
and it wasn't too long ago. Like
my dad, you know, like the Kermit?
Yeah.
My dad bought that at like £2,000, like whenever it first came out. Like, and he has it right
2006?
Now. Yeah. Like whenever, must have been that,
yeah.
I think he said he paid like $2,000 or $3,000.
Well, nobody wanted them, yeah.
Yeah. And then they just went crazy.
Even directly from the dealer, they would give you discounts.
Yeah.
The one that did drop a lot is the Starbucks. That one now it's like 15.
It's not like the new Kermit, basically.
What about the GMT? Like the Batman, Sprite?
I had a Batman. The Sprite I think is cool. I don't know, I just haven't got around to like buying one.
Yeah.
I think it's cool, and I honestly do think that will be a crazy investment. Not now, but one day.
Maybe, right?
Because if they stopped doing that other side of the thing, and then that was the only ever Rolex that had it like that, that will be crazy.
We have
the
Jubilee one.
Oh, yeah, let me see it.
I've
never set the time on any watch. I think one day that will be crazy. Yeah. If they discontinue it. That would be crazy. The one that I think is good is the Wimbledon, the rose gold one. I like that. I just like the colors, the rose nice with the gray and the green. Like, that's a good mix.
A lot of people, when they buy these like gold watches, they don't even use them.
Yeah, I used to wear it, bro. You know what I mean? But I never get polished. I'll just leave it because I buy it brand new. Don't want to polish it down. If someone wants to polish it down, that's on them. You know what I mean? Because I remember one time I bought Sky-Dweller champagne face, and I didn't realize for ages, and I was like, bro, it's been polished so many times, the edges aren't even straight anymore. Mm-hmm. Like, that's crazy.
It depends who polishes.
As well, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
But you can do mad now with the gold. You can like fill the chips back in.
Even,
like,
well, even with the steel,
they weld
like other pieces of steel, and then
that's crazy.
So, guys, the business owner is still talking to the client.
Cool.
It's going to take a little bit, I think.
All right, cool. You got my number.
It's a big purchase, and we have to be sure that he's going to buy it.
Yeah, obviously.
But it seems like he's interested.
All right, cool.
So, don't go far.
Cool. And just to be clear, if he wanted to buy it, what would you guys be able to offer?
That's what I'm finding out right now.
All
right,
cool.
We're more than fair.
Yeah.
So, if the money is there, I'll beat it.
Cool.
Well.
Cool.
All right, so we'll wait for the call, see if we can buy it.
I think it'll be 37.
Probably. All right, bye. tell him to go get the 36 if he really has that offer. If not, our offer's 34. We sell it for 36.5.
At this time, I'm not able to meet that because that's typically around what we, you know, resell them for, that area.
Wholesale.
Our best offer right now would be 34,000 for the watch. Okay, got it. Told already.
No.
He said if he needs something, he'll be in touch with us.
Wow. All right. Too little money for us. No good.